This episode, I have to say, not only was it the last, but it was one of the most beautiful ones. I choked up, I'm not gonna lie, because I enjoy the ending song so much. I haven't skipped it, and I just automatically think of the dad, like Byakuya and the rest of the gang. There was just, it's just touching to me, you know, and to see in this episode having them another contribution, a major one, that be at it, like, it was just great. And I really enjoy that the message that was given was very, very awesome. It moved everyone, and it was just enjoyable. Overall, I didn't think that this last episode would be as entertaining as it was. But let's go ahead and get started. So we finally have the cell phone created. However, we have a major problem. We have no other cell phone. Like, we can transmit the message, but we can't deliver it. So they have to make another. But in all of this, they are able to find a way to communicate with two ends, which is awesome. I really enjoy that they were able to do this. We got a little bit of teasing on Ginro's part to get Chrome to admit his feelings. That doesn't happen, of course, but I do still think that the message that Chrome is able to deliver was still a nice one. He does want to get Ruri moved, and sure enough, we do see her later on being moved by Chrome's words and admitting that science is in fact beautiful. Personally, science is cool. I don't think it's the most beautiful. I love nature, you know, I love all that. But I did enjoy, you know, how everyone is really now truly on the side of building, and, you know, they're excited, you know, and it's just moving to them. And so when we make this discovery, accidentally, really, when we have Ruri actually talking about a speaker, and that was one of the 100 tales, and it being revealed from one of the tombstones, Byakuya's tombstone, actually being the one that held onto the secret. You know, I love how Senku's like very intelligent, but he's also able to be moved, and we see that, like, even a little bit, you know, seeing how he's able to listen to his father one last time through this recording. You know, and the concept of it was something that was beyond them. And so I do like that Senku explained it. I personally, too, I'm going to say this, I didn't know how records worked. And I think there was a fascinating way to do it. Obviously, we now have digital, and we had CDs and, you know, all of that. But still, you know, to be able to, you know, do that with recordings, I thought that was just really cool. I really, really enjoyed that. So it was a nice little explanation and, you know, moment there. You know, we all, like I said, we got to see the past with Lillian actually singing. That was a very touching moment, I think. You know, we know what happened to them, you know, how they, well, some of them died, how they did, and I just enjoyed it. Lillian singing was a sweet, sweet moment. Everyone was able to listen. Like I said, Senku was moved. And I love how Byakuya adds on to the, you know, if they're having a tough time being on your side, then play them this. And like I said before, they were already on his side, but now they're like 10 billion percent, there we go, on his side. And I really enjoyed that. I really, really did. I thought it was really fun. I thought it was really cool. And it was just fun, you know, to see them all on board. And then as we get closer to the episode, we get to see Gen actually saying, you know, Lillian was great. You know, I feel like now your guilt has kind of been alleviated from, you know, having the village go into war. And, you know, I never thought of that. And I think that Senku did too. How, like, he did, you know, he is having them go to war, and it's probably one of the toughest things he's probably has to swallow. But I think now he's feeling better about it. I do think that the village now has a real good fighting chance, and they're just ready to go into it. But I also really enjoyed, and I kind of was disappointed on the screen time that we get Yuzuriha and Taijiro. It was like Taijiro, excuse me. It was like very limited. Same footage we got from like the opening, and that's another thing. I'm gonna miss the opening, man. I'm gonna miss it so much. I love that song. It was one of the best for me and this year, and I still have it on repeat on my phone. I just love listening to it, and just, you know, having them, you know that Senku was alive. It's been about a year since they've seen each other, but of course, we do have the spies listening to their conversation. We have Tsukasa getting ready for war. And it's crazy because we have confirmation, guys. If you all didn't already know, we have confirmation that Season 2 is happening. We don't know when. I'm hoping that next year, possibly around this time. Now, that's just my guess, that it'll come out next year around this time. And, you know, I could be wrong. It could come out maybe a year after. I hope not. The fandom for this has grown, I feel like, a lot. And it definitely deserves. This anime has really been one of the most entertaining ones for me. It's been very different. And I think that's probably why I've enjoyed this. And at the end of this video, guys, I'm going to show you one of my favorite moments. I hope you guys enjoyed. Hope you guys have enjoyed me reviewing. But let me know. Comments down below. Stay safe, guys. And I will catch you later.